Hello, everybody, and welcome to Managerial Accounting. This is Absorption versus Variable Costing. This is part three, part two. Well, I mean, the second time I'm going through and doing this video. We have no beginning inventory, but we do have an ending inventory. So let's go through and check this out. Okay. So right over here, we had sales of 38,000 units during 2025, and I produced 40,000 units, and I had no beginning inventory. So when we look at this over here in terms of this particular question, I produced 40,000 units. I sold 38,000 of them. So I have an ending inventory of 2,000 units. And this number is going to be very important for us because this is going to help us explain our difference. So this is the same facts as in the prior equation and the prior question, but let's go through and do this anyways. So over here, we're going to prepare an absorption costing income statement. Let's go ahead and start with that. And we also need to determine the cost per unit under variable and absorption costing. So let's go ahead and get right to that. So for my cost per unit under variable costing, and then we're going to have absorption costing. Okay, so what goes into variable? My direct materials, my direct labor, my variable overhead. And then for the fixed factory overhead, this is not going to be applicable. Why? Because when we have our fixed factory overhead under variable costing, we're going to go ahead and expense that immediately. So my direct materials under variable costing are $40 per unit. Direct labor is $50 per unit. For my variable overhead, my total variable overhead costs were $1.5 million. Now, to figure out my per unit, I'm going to take $1,500,000. I'm going to divide it not by the units sold, but by the units produced, or 40,000 units. So this is going to be 1.5 million divided by 40,000. So this is going to give me $37.50 per unit. So this example is a little bit different because in the prior one, we produced and sold 50,000. So we're going to come up with some different numbers here, but it's all good. So my cost per unit under variable costing is going to be $127.50. Under absorption costing, my direct materials are the same, my direct labor is the same, my variable overhead is the same. However, when it comes to fixed factory overhead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my $4 million. I'm going to take my $4 million of fixed factory overhead and divide it by the 40,000 units produced. So this part over here, this is going to be 4 million divided by 40,000, or a total of $100 per unit. My cost per unit under absorption costing is going to be $227.50. So now that we have this information, let's go to it. We'll go ahead and do the absorption costing income statement first. So over here, I have my sales. My units sold, though, are 38,000. So if I sold 38,000 units, my sales price per unit is $339. So my total sales for this particular problem we have here is going to be 38,000 times 339, or 12,882,000, less my cost of goods sold. Very important. If I sold 38,000 units, I need to take 38,000 units to cost of goods sold. My sales price per unit is, or excuse me, my cost per unit is going to be $227.50. So my total cost of goods sold is going to be 38,000 times $227.50, or $8,645,000. So my gross profit is going to be $4,237. To finish up my absorption costing income statement, I'm now going to go ahead and say less my selling, general, and administrative costs. So here I've got two. I have my sales commissions. I sold 38,000. So I need over here my $30 per unit of my sales commissions. Right over here. So I've got total sales commissions of $1,140,000. I also had fixed SXG&A, fixed selling general administrative costs of $800,000. So over here, my total SG&A is going to be $1,940,000. So my net income under absorption costing, or the traditional costing, is going to be my gross profit minus my SG&A, or $2,297,000. Let's go ahead and look at our variable costing. Right. So as we saw from the previous example, my sales are going to be the same. I'm selling 38,000 units for $339 per unit for a total of $12,882,000. But for my variable costs, okay, so if I sold 38,000 units, I need to take 38,000 units to my cost of goods sold. So my variable cost of goods sold is going to be right over here at $127.50 per unit. So over here, I've got $127.50 per unit. Let's make this big for everybody. So over here, my variable cost of goods sold is going to be $4,845. I also am going to have as a variable cost, I'm going to have my sales commissions. This is $38,000 at $30 per unit. Remember, my sales commissions, it's a variable cost. So over here, this is going to be $1,140,000. So my total variable costs are going to be $4,845,000 plus $1,140,000, $5,985,000. So my contribution margin, which is going to be my sales minus my variable costs, is going to be $6,897,000. Then what I need to do, so I'm going to say less my fixed costs. Big one here, fixed factory overhead. My fixed factory overhead is $4 million. That gets expensed immediately. Think about it. We're expensing the entire amount right now. So, and then we have my fixed SG&A. That's the exact same as absorption. So my total fixed costs are going to be $4.8 million, and my net income under variable costing is going to be $6,897,000 minus $4.8 million, or $2,097,000. Okay. Now, if I look at this here, my net income under absorption costing was $2,297,000. My net income under variable costing is going to be $2,097,000. Okay. So big question is, what is causing this difference? Got a difference of $200,000. Why is absorption $200,000 higher than variable? Now, the one thing I always want you to remember is it's always going to be in the fixed factory overhead. If you think about it, this full $4 million was being expensed. However, under absorption, did we fully expense that $4 million? The answer is no. And why? Because we had 2,000 units that we produced, but we did not sell. So there are fixed factory overhead costs sitting in the ending inventory. If I look over here and I say that my ending inventory, we said that ending inventory was 2,000 units. I produced 40,000, but I only sold 38, so I have 2,000 left over. My fixed factory overhead per unit is going to be at $100. If I take my total So the total amount of fixed factory overhead that is in my ending inventory under absorption is going to be $2,000 times $100 per unit, or a total of $200,000. So this is where the difference is coming from. The only difference between these methodologies is what happens with our fixed factory overhead per unit. And as we can go through and see, especially with this example over here, it's coming basically when I go through and do it, it's $200,000 higher. Why? Because I fully expense this $4 million. I only expensed, in terms of the fixed factory overhead, I sold 38,000 units, so I only expensed $3.8 million. That's the only amount of this that went into cost of goods sold. So that difference of $200,000 is what's causing my income to be higher under absorption costing. So I want to thank you for joining me here today. Please leave any questions you might have below, and appreciate your liking and subscribing to these videos. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great day.